I'm optimistic in that fact. And from my standpoint, 3 years with the organization, I don't have the tenure that many other cooperative leaders have, but I've noticed in the last 3 months I've had a greater opportunity to dialogue with more of those individuals than I did in the previous 2.5 years. And I'm optimistic that that opportunity will continue and that we will be able to come together. In many respects, for our organization, I hope for that direction from our members and from our elected officials. My role is to help facilitate that, to make sure that they have the information and the knowledge for them to make those decisions. And I've struggled a little bit in wondering why more action has not taken place when those leaders of cooperatives are dairy farmers themselves. That tells me that the structure within that system probably is not where it needs to be, especially during a crisis. But I'm optimistic that those folks are able to sit at the table and for national level to come out with their four-prong approach and wisdom that they have. I think that, as Dave said earlier, the devil is in the details. We haven't yet been able to see the details where those details have been developed. But in any type of plan you have, if you don't have detail, you're not going to be satisfied with the result of that plan or that program when it comes up. People want transparency. People want to know exactly what it means for them. And that's why I asked the Producers Association, in terms of this rebate, this bonus check that producers could get if they did not change their production. What's that really mean to me as an individual farmer? Sure, you have a rebate for me. I've seen that before. Oh, you'll have a bonus for me. Yeah. It'll never come. But looking at some of those simple logistics that Lucas did that for me, I could at least say, hypothetically, if production was here and production increased by X amount, you as a dairy and producer, a dairy woman producing X amount of milk, could get an $8,000 check at the end of the year if you kept your production the same. Hypothetically, but it's information that's useful.
I got some more dairy producer questions.
Following up on the head, for 60 years, the ag lenders, major ag lenders in the state of Wisconsin, I think it was the family dairy in Madison, that are concerned that it will take 5 or 5 to 10 years to build that equity back up from 1 year of losses. And to that end, I'm concerned about the infrastructure. When I was at World Dairy Expo, I was at a table talking to some gentlemen, and they ran all of the United States. And he was at a dealership in Montana. And while he was there, a farmer called up. And by the conversation on the phone, he asked the dealership, well, the guy called up and apparently bought a new tractor from the dealership, but wasn't in yet. He called up and stated that the hydraulics went out on the tractor he traded. And if he wanted to make the deal different, the farmer said, I'll agree to that because I traded it off with a good working order. But the dealer said, no, I'm satisfied that you called me. And the distributor was there and said, not for that company, but he said, why didn't you call and tell you that? He said, I'll tell you why, because I am 280 miles away from him. And if he owes me, the next dealership is 500 miles. So I'm concerned that we will start losing infrastructure because in my area, the machine dealers, the veterinarian dealers, the fertilizer, the seed, the fuel are all lacking dollars. Some are borrowing money to stay in business as a dealer or as a business. And number one of the plans up there had that the competitive edge, we had a competitive edge, but as we learned in the previous one, we lost market share, so I don't know if the competitive edge, it doesn't do a lot in the gasoline industry or fuel industry. When prices were $4 a gallon, there were barges off of the shores waiting to unload. There was no place to put it, everything was full up, so I don't know if the competitive edge is an advantage. And lastly, one of the programs had insurance on there. It was crop insurance, health insurance, and fire insurance, and liability insurance. I'm fed up with that part of it. Thank you.
sure, did you have a question about the rest of the year?
Well,
the competitive edge.
Yeah, and the competitive edge and the insurance part. I don't know if that's a strong part of any program, but I just don't care to have that. One of those competitive edge, I don't think that's going to be a positive force.
I can handle that with kid gloves since that's my father.